and the mechanisms underlying this, like kind of surprising discovery that why the embryos release cell-free DNA to the culture media. So we established a collaboration with Nicolas Plaza and with the Boston IVF, for sure together with Carlos Simon and Carlos Simon Foundation. They are very nice with this live imaging, and we have a postdoc working there in finding the best approach to stain the embryos at the latest stages of embryo development without injection. And this is the technology that they are applying in cleavage stay embryos, and now this is working very nicely in blastocysts. So these results were partially presented last year in the SRM. We have been trying to identify something to be related to the release of the cell-free DNA. We are at the early stages, but it has been very nice to see how we can start to see small blebs from the cells of the blastocyst, that we are observing a phenomenon related to the expansion of the blastocyst. So once the blastocyst is more expanded with a higher cavity and with a higher pressure of the trophectoderm cells, we observe that this phenomenon increases with the pressed nuclei, and maybe this could be related. We have not seen now how the cell-free DNA is going outside, but we are identifying some mechanisms that maybe can explain why this release of cell-free DNA start to be really very apparent from day 5 to day 6. And the results of this study are going to be published in Cell next week, 5th of July, online. So we are really very grateful for this collaboration with Nicolas Plaza.